Hey folks, Arm & Hammer here, and today I wanted to talk to you about how the new CrossFit Games format is going to affect the age groups. That's right, today we're talking teens and masters. So still, to this day, one of the most common questions I'm receiving is, what is going to happen with the teens and the masters? Well, in one of my old videos, I talked about some details that I heard from Greg Glassman and Jeff Kane regarding the age groups, and the general gist of it is that not much is going to change. Still going to qualify for the age group online qualifier through the open, still gonna qualify for the games through the age group online qualifier. But now that we have more details about how the actual games format is going to work, it makes a little bit more sense to look at what's gonna actually happen at the games when the age groups get there. So we know that at the games, we're gonna have a huge field of competitors on the individual side, and that during the first portion of the week, they're going to get narrowed down to a very small field, maybe even as small as a field of 10 individual athletes. What does this have to do with the age groups? Well, when you have a field that small, the logistics of putting on a competition become a little bit more challenging. You need to find a way to give athletes downtime they need in order to be ready for the next event of the day. And that is where the age groups come in. Now, historically, the age groups have been kind of neglected, pushed aside in their own little pavilion, and no one goes to watch them and see these athletes compete. So now the idea is to take a smaller group of athletes from the teens and the masters, not like there's less divisions, but there are just less athletes per division. And they're going to be using them as kind of like an intermission or a halftime show between the main events of the individuals. I think it pulls the masters athletes out of their own little black hole that no one is watching and puts them front and center and actually gives them more of a stage to compete in while also helping break up the pace for the individual and team competitions. It seems to me one of the biggest benefits of this isn't just pulling the age group qualifiers out of the pavilion and putting them on the main stage. It actually helps make the entirety of the games a much more interesting and exciting event to spectate. Because for everything that the CrossFit Games has had going for it, it hasn't really been an exciting spectator sport. The teams are generally difficult to follow and quite boring unless you're in the last heat. Same with the individuals, where the first heat or two, sometimes even the first three of four heats, aren't that exciting to watch. And finally, the age groups, the teens and the masters, they just kind of get shunned aside and no one even watches the competition unless you're related to one of the people competing, which is an absolute shame. So that's definitely one of the things that I'm most pumped about when it comes to this new format for the CrossFit Games, is that the actual experience of the competition in person and as a spectator, whether you're there in person or watching online, is going to be more exciting. And that is really a benefit for all of us. Remember folks, there's a whole lot going on in our space and it's easy to miss some of the most interesting and exciting stories. That is what I'm here for. I'll see you guys next time.